Hi guys, welcome to my first ever YouTube video. I am going to be doing a tutorial for you today on the makeup look that you see right here. It's a very fiery, coppery eye with a dramatic black lip. Sorry for the voiceover intro. I was going to film one in person, however, when I tried it, I found out that I'm very bad at them right now. So I'm gonna keep practicing and hopefully get a little bit more comfortable in front of the camera and do an in-person one in future. But let's get started with the tutorial. First, I'm gonna start off with skincare, which is really, really important for your makeup to have really hydrated skin so that everything goes on smoothly. Here you can see me applying my moisturizer, which is the First Aid Beauty Ultra Repair Cream. This stuff is amazing. It doesn't make you greasy or oily at all, and I do have a little bit of an oilier T-zone, but this just hydrates your skin without leaving any sort of grease. Next is eye creams. I'm using the Ole Henriksen Fresh Start Eye Cream. I've been using this for a few months now, and I'm not sure I've noticed a huge difference, but it does do a good job for hydration, and again, it doesn't make your concealer wear off or greasy or anything like that. So just tapping that on underneath my eyes, and then while that skincare is sinking in, we're gonna go straight to the eye makeup. Because I am gonna be using a pigment layer, I wanted to do the eyes before my foundation just to make sure that any fallout could be easily wiped away. So here you see me applying some tape to the corner of my eye. That's just gonna help get a really crisp line, but I am gonna be taking this tape off and you'll see why. So right now I'm just applying a light bit of shadow to the outside of my eye, and this is to just get a gauge of how well my tape is placed. So I'm gonna take it off, see that line, I'm liking the way it looks even with the other side. So now I'm gonna go back in and reapply some tape to actually start the eye. Now I'm taking the color Frisk from the Urban Decay Naked 2 Basics palette, just a really nice neutral light shadow, and I'm going in with the Fluffy Blending Brush from Makeup Forever. I love this brush, it's so soft and does a really great job blending. And I'm just going to apply this to the outer part of my eye to get a feel for the shape of the eyeshadow that I'm going to be creating. Now I'm going in with the Kathleen Lights eyeshadow from ColourPop. This is part of her quad Where the Light Is. I really love it, it's a gorgeous coppery color. And I'm just patting that all over the outer two-thirds of my eye with the pad of my finger and kind of keeping it on the lid, not going too high into the crease. Now I'm taking a domed synthetic brush. This is from the Shade and Light Eye Brush from Kat Von D, and I'm just going to blend out the edges of that so we get a really smooth transition, and just any kind of synthetic brush is going to work really well for this with the ColourPop shadow. Now I'm going back in with some more of that pigment just so again to build up any color we lost, and then I'm just blending it out again. So this kind of the theme to this, it's going to be a lot of putting on product and then blending it out. Next I'm going in with the Sephora Glitter Eyeshadow Base, and I'm going in with the other side of that Kat Von D brush, and I'm just applying a bit of this to the outer corner V-shape of that look. And now for the star of the show, this is the NYX Ultra Pearl Mania. So it's a pigment from NYX, a loose pigment, and I'm going in with the shade Rust, with just this fantastic fiery copper color. And I'm putting that on the outer part of my eye here, you can see on that wing, and I'm just working to blend it really nicely in with that copper color. And again, you can see the theme of placing and then buffing and then placing and then buffing, just to make sure that everything is blended, but that we also keep the amount of pigment that we want. And you really just want to concentrate that pigment on the outer part of the eye to get that nice gradient. Next, I'm going in with the Jumbo Eyeshadow Pencil from NYX in the color Milk, and I'm putting that on that inner third of the eye that we haven't put any eyeshadow on yet. And I'm just going to blend that out with my finger. Now I'm going in with the Butterscotch Caramel shade from the NYX Hot Singles eyeshadow, and I'm just taking a Real Techniques, I think this is a lip brush, but it was small, so it worked for my purposes. So we're going to use that on the eyes instead, and I'm just going to apply that yellow shadow again to the inner third of the eye and just keep building it up until it is the intensity that you want it to be. And I am going to run that yellow sort of all along the top of the shape of the eye I'm creating, just kind of blend everything really well together to connect the outer part and the inner part and just make it all look really smooth and uniform. Now I'm going in with some more of that Kathleen light shadow, again, just to highlight the center, make it pop, because we did lose a little bit of that color with the pigment and the yellow. And just to deepen that outer portion a little bit more, I'm going in with Hot Fudge from the Too Faced Semi-Sweet Chocolate Bar palette, and I'm just going to put a little of that on the outer corner of the eye. Not too much, I don't want to make it look brown, I just want to make it look like a slightly darker version of that rust color. And now I'm going back in with that Makeup Forever blending brush just to make sure that even after adding all those new shadows, everything is still nice and blended. So now it's time to take off that tape and do the rest of our faces. I'm going to go in with a big fluffy brush to take off any pigment that may have fallen down onto my cheeks. And then it's time to apply primer. So I'm going in with the Makeup Forever Hydrating Primer and the Smoothing one, and I'm just gonna mix a bit of those together and apply them all over. If you do have really oily skin, you might want to use more of a mattifying primer, but my skin isn't super oily, so I thought I'd go more for the hydration since it is winter. I need a little bit more to keep my skin from getting dry, and then the smoothing one is just gonna help to conceal any sort of texture or pores you may have going on your face. Now that our skin is all primed and ready to go, it's time for foundation. Today I'm using the L'Oreal Paris Infallible Pro Matte Foundation. Mine is in the shade 101 Classic Ivory, and I am going to be applying that with the Sephora Pro Airbrush Blender Brush. Try saying that 5 times fast. I love this brush, it's amazing. It's so dense, it doesn't soak up any of your foundation, just puts it right onto your skin, so it gives you really full coverage and it blends out beautifully. It does suck to clean, but for applying foundation, this is my absolute favorite. I chose to use the Pro Matte Foundation for this look because I wanted to be matte. I didn't want super glowy skin or anything for this look, but I also wanted my skin to look alive, and because I wasn't gonna be adding any highlighter to it, I didn't want it to look totally sort of flat and lifeless. So I think that the L'Oreal Pro Matte does a really good job of that because it is a semi-matte, which means it's going to not look shiny, it's not gonna look glowy or anything, but it's still gonna give your skin a little bit of life so you don't look too flat, which I think is perfect. It also does give like a medium to full coverage, I'd say, which is really good for a dramatic look where you really want your skin to look flawless. So now it is time to conceal, and I'm going in with the Maybelline Master Conceal Camouflage and Concealer. Mine is in the shade 10 Fair, and I'm going to be using a Sigma Tapered Kabuki F86 brush to blend this all in. And I'm just going to apply this for areas where I need a little bit more coverage, so under the eyes, around my nose, and around the corners of my mouth, I tend to get a little bit red. Same with my nose, I find that's where my foundation wears off first, so I like to put a little bit of extra concealer in that area. And I was also having a little bit of a breakout in between my eyebrows, so I put a little bit in there as well. Now with this, I'm not so much highlighting as just concealing those dark circles and redness areas. I am going in with a different product in a second to highlight. So now to highlight, as well as adding just a little bit extra coverage as well, because I do want a really, really flawless look for this, I am going in with the Sephora Collection Smoothing and Brightening Concealer in the shade Light 02. And with this, I'm going to apply it under my eyes, in the center of my forehead. I'm applying some around my brows as well. And then I'm also gonna go down the center of my nose, my upper lip, my chin. And you'll see I'm gonna apply a little bit on the sides of my face as well, just underneath where I'm going to apply my contour, just to kind of help carve those cheeks out. Now I know this is a lot of concealer to apply using two different concealers. It's definitely more than I would wear on a day-to-day basis. For every day, I normally just go in with my Sephora Collection one because it's a little bit of a lighter coverage. But for this look, because it is more dramatic, I am going all out, and I really wanted to have a very flawless coverage, so lots of concealer and lots of brightness as well. So that is the only reason why I'm going in with two today. You can definitely only go in with one if you don't feel like using two concealers. Now now I'm going in with the NYX Wonder Stick to contour. I'm using the shade Light Medium, and I wanted to go in with the cream contour first just because I want it to be quite intense for this look. So I'm going to start off with the cream base, and I'm using that contouring side of the stick to carve out my cheekbones. I'm going to apply a little bit along the edge of my jawline to help define that, as well as the sides of my nose to help make it look a little bit slimmer and straighter. And because I am a member of the Large Forehead Club, I'm going to go in and contour that as well. So I'm just going to apply it all along the edges of my forehead to kind of help bring it down to a more normal size. And then because I thought that the concealer I'd applied to my cheeks just wasn't quite as intense as I want it to be, I'm applying the lighter side of that contouring duo underneath my cheekbones as well as down the bridge of my nose. Now for some more Makeup Forever Mist and Fix, I'm just going to spray that all over my face, and that's just going to make it a little bit easier to blend out this contour. I'm using a brush from the Sephora Collection Flatter Yourself Contouring Brush Set to buff that all out. I find that it works really, really well to blend out cream contour. Unfortunately, they don't sell it individually, but any sort of dense synthetic brush is going to work really well for blending out any sort of cream contouring product. Because my concealer has been sitting for a little while I've been contouring, I'm just going to go back in with some Makeup Forever Mist and Fix to rehydrate under my eyes and make sure it's not settling or creasing at all before going in to set it with powder. I'm taking some Ben Nye Luxury Powder in the shade Cameo on a Real Techniques sponge, and I'm going to be baking under my eyes as well as any areas where I really want to make sure my foundation is not going to wear off. I'm sure you've seen baking before, it is all over YouTube, it's a great way to heavy duty set your concealer or foundation, and it is more intense, so it's not great to do for a super natural makeup look, but for something really dramatic like what we've got going on today, it is perfect. So I'm going to be applying that to the center of my face, anywhere where I might get a little bit oilier, and I'm also going in underneath that contour to really sharpen it up and make sure it is super crisp. Now to up the drama on our faces even more, I'm going in with some powder contour. So I'm using the shade Toffee from the NYX Highlight and Contour Pro Palette, and I'm going to be applying that with the Tarte Swirl Contouring Brush. This brush is amazing. The shape is perfect. You can get a really sharp line, as you can see I'm applying right there. But then because the top is nice and fluffy, you can go out and blend it, which is what I'm going to do later, and it makes it perfect. You can do a really dramatic contour with this brush. You can do a really soft contour. It does everything. I love it so much, and it's so soft. So now you can see I'm just going back in everywhere where I applied that powder, and I'm just going to blend it out and make sure there's no harsh lines. Because while we want it to be dramatic, we still want it to be nice and blended. And now I'm just going in with a big fluffy brush just to brush away all of that excess powder that we applied earlier to set our concealer. And of course, gotta smooth down those baby hairs because they are popping up. Next it is time for blush, and I'm going to go in with this bright red one. It is the Urban Decay Afterglow Blush in the shade Fang. It's absolutely gorgeous, and I'm using a really floppy, light, fluffy brush because I do not want to apply too much of this because it gets really intense really fast. But you can see how gorgeous it looks with just a light layer applied. And then on the other side, I applied way too much and it turned out bright red. So now I have to go back into the first side, and even though that's exactly the way I wanted it to be, I had to add a little bit more so that they would be even. Now I'm going in with a flat top kabuki brush. This one is from Sigma. It's just a clean foundation brush, and I was going to use that to try and buff out the blush a little bit because it was still a little bit too intense for what I wanted. I went back in with the brush we used for our concealer, and I'm not putting any extra concealer on there, but I'm just using whatever remnants is still on there just to kind of help tone down that blush a little bit. So I ended up getting it to the right sort of intensity, but it would have been a lot easier if I had used a lighter hand to begin with. So now to finish up the eyes, I'm going in with some more of the Kathleen Lights ColourPop Shadow, and I'm taking the brush that came with the Urban Decay Electric Palette, and I'm going to use that to apply the Kathleen Lights Shadow to the entire lower lash line. And then on the same Kat Von D brush we were using earlier, I'm using the pencil side to apply the rust pigment to the outer portion of the eye, and then taking the yellow shadow, I'm going to apply that to the inner portion. So doing the exact same thing we did on the top lid to the lower lid. For liner, I'm going in with my NYC Black Liquid Liner. I am grinning at how beat up it is because all of the lettering has worn off, but this liner is fantastic. It has a very precise tip, which is perfect for applying a nice thin wing, which is what I want to do today. I don't want anything too big or bold because I really want the eyeshadow to be the star of this look, but I do want a nice wing to sort of frame the eye, and because it is really dramatic, I think that a winged liner complements that perfectly. Now I'm going in with my Tarte Eyelash Curler to curl them lashes. Unfortunately, the one with the pearl handle that I have was from a holiday collection, so you can't get that one anymore, but you can get their normal one with the purple handle, and it is a fantastic curler. I highly recommend it. For mascara, I'm going in with the L'Oreal Voluminous Butterfly Mascara in Midnight Black, and I'm applying a generous couple of layers to both eyes. So now, skipping all of the cursing and eye watering that accompanied me violently stabbing myself in the eye with the mascara wand, we are going to jump forward to applying false lashes. I'm going to be using the Ardell Wispy Lashes today. They're really nice, sort of dramatic, but still kind of natural lashes. I'm using some Duo Eyelash Glue that's going to dry clear, as well as my little Duo Eyelash Applicator, which is a savior. It makes putting on false lashes so much easier than trying to use your fingers. You can see the difference with one eye having the lash on and one eye just with mascara, and I do think the false lashes just add that nice extra bit of drama that is perfect for this look. Now that we've got both of our lashes on, it is time for eyeliner. So I'm going in with the Urban Decay 24/7 Glide On Eyeliner in the shade 0, a really nice black creamy eyeliner, and I'm just going to be applying this to my waterline on both eyes just to really finish off that lower lash line. Since we did go in with false lashes, I wanted to give the lower lashes a bit of a boost so they didn't look too spindly. I'm going to be using the Tarte Opening Act Lash Primer in order to build up the lower lashes and make them a little bit thicker and longer underneath the mascara. That primer just 10 to 15 seconds to set a little bit. I'm going back in with that Voluminous Butterfly Mascara and applying it to the lower lashes, and this time I did manage not to stab myself in the eye. By the way, I absolutely love the way this mascara smells. I don't know what it is, I just cannot get enough of it. To finally finish off this look, I'm going in with a black lipstick from Wet n Wild. This is the shade Blackout, and they come out with it every year for Halloween. I picked it up for like $2 back in October, and it is a decent drugstore black lipstick. It's quite pigmented, and it is really comfortable. However, because it is on the creamier side, it's not gonna wear well for long term. It does feather a little bit. It did slide around on me. So I suggest if you're wanting something that's a little bit more durable, go for a liquid lipstick like from Kat Von D or Anastasia. However, if you want just something cheap from the drugstore, this one is pretty good. Lastly, I'm using the Urban Decay Black Eyeliner that we used previously just to even out my lips a little bit and give the lipstick a nice crisp edge. And there you have it. That is the final look complete. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I really loved filming this for you. If you liked it, please give it a big thumbs up and subscribe if you want to see more videos from me. And until next time, thank you so much and have a great week, you guys.